What's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can create key events in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Welcome back, everyone. In this video, we're going to be discussing key events. We can bind a key event and a function to a widget or a window, so that when we press a certain key or do something, we can trigger a function to be called that will perform some sort of task for us. So we can actually do this by using the bind function. So widgets and windows have access to a bind function. So when our window or our widget is selected and then you press a certain key or do something, then it's going to call a certain function to perform a task for us. So there's two arguments within the bind function. This takes an event as well as a function name. Let's say that when we press the enter key, we want to call this function to do something. So for this event, what we type for that is a set of quotes, angle brackets, and the name of the button. So for example, if you want to press W to move forward, like you're playing a game, this would be W, A, S, D. There's also up, down, and then let's say we want to press enter to do something. That is actually a return. And then we will call this function. So let's create a function called do something. And let's define this at the top. Def do something. Now pay attention to this part. We need to set up one parameter for this do something function. This needs an event, so be sure to include that, and it's easy to forget. So what do we want to do after we press enter? Let's just print a message. You did a thing. And this should work now. So let's try it. So while this window has focus ability, we can actually have this respond to events. So right now I'm pressing all sorts of keys. You can probably hear me right now going crazy on my keyboard. But now I'm going to hit enter. And it says, you did a thing. And you can bind all sorts of keys to this window. Let's say that I want to press Q to quit. So we'll just replace this with lowercase q. So I'm typing all sorts of keys, but now I'm going to press Q and it says you did a thing. Kind of like we're quitting the game. You can actually have this respond to all keys, well, almost all of them. So to do that, you just type in key with a capital K. So I can pretty much press on any key, then it's going to trigger or call our function. Kind of like that. So one thing that we could do, we can display the key event that was pressed. So I'm just going to add that here. Maybe I'll change this message. You pressed plus, and to display what key was pressed, that is event dot key sim. I believe that's for key symbol. So this will actually display what button you pressed. So WASD. Here's a unique idea for practice. Let's say that we want to add a label to our window and we're going to change the text on the label to reflect whatever key that we press. So let's create a label. Label equals label. We're adding this to our window. And let's change the font as well to something massive like Helvetica. And a size of 100. That should be good. Then we need to pack this label. So label.pack. Then within this function, let's turn this into a comment. And we're going to use label.config. And we're going to update our text. And the text is going to be whatever key that we press. So we can do that with event.keySim. So now this label is going to display whatever key that we press. So for an example, WASD, backspace, escape, up, up, down, down, left, right, BA start. All right, so that's the basics of key events. If you could do me a favor and in the comments down below, just press F to pay respects. So if you want a copy of this code, I'll post this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of key events in Python. Hey you, yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.